let's see what exactly we had done in the previous lecture, and then we can start with today's topics. Just have a quick recap of what we saw in simplification of CFG. As we know that simplification of CFG can be done in three ways. First of all, we can get rid of all those useless productions. Then we can get rid of all those unit productions. And third, null productions. Order may change. Okay. So we saw that useless productions are those productions which are, first of all, non-generating. That is, no terminals can be generated or derived from them. Secondly, the second condition basically for unit productions are that it should not be reachable from the starting symbol. Whether if a particular variable is not reachable from the starting symbol, whether directly or indirectly, then we can say that it is generally having no effect on the derivation of the grammar. Hence, we can say that that particular variable is not reachable and useless. Similarly, the third one is having infinite loops or self loops in between. So if a production is having only so basically if a production is being called within itself and that is the only production available with it, then we may call it as a self-looped variable and we are having no effect of that variable on the actual derivation of the grammar. So hence we remove it. These were a few examples we saw, self-loop, etc., etc. So these are the problems. Kindly practice it once again. Okay, so this was the first type. Second type was null productions. As we saw that null productions are those which actually have a null unit or null symbol on the right hand side of the production. So these are examples of null production. We saw that how we can get rid of all those null productions by simply substituting that null production in the left hand side variable itself and then substituting that variable wherever it is being called. This is how we get rid of null productions. And finally, we saw what are unit productions. Unit productions are the simplest. As you can see over here, this is a unit production, and to get rid of it, we need to get rid of all those productions which are causing the unit production. So hence, over here, A is causing the unit production, and we are simply replacing the each and every occurrence of A with its production root. Simple. So this is how we solve such problems of simplification. So we can start with our next topic, which is what we call as normal forms. Okay, so basically we have two normal forms, that is Chomsky's normal form and Grebash's normal form. From here we are starting our today's lecture. First of all, I had explained to you that normal forms are basically used to derive a sentence or derive a grammar in a particular format. Normal forms, as we all know, they are basically used to structure our data, whether it may be your DBMS subject, database management systems, or TCS, that is theory of computer science. The structure is very important. For example, you know that in case of grammar, if I write something like this, let me quickly change the width. Yeah. If I write something like this, and if I write something like this, both are having different meaning, right? So we have to have a certain structure which will basically define our entire grammar. Right? So normal forms are those mechanisms or those techniques by which we can define a structure for a grammar or for the production rule. So these are the two types which are called as Chomsky's normal form. As we have seen, as we have already seen Chomsky's hierarchy, the same person have basically designed this technique which is called as Chomsky's normal form. And second type is Grebash's normal form, that is GNF. First is CNF and second is GNF. The questions kaise aayenge, let me tell you. The questions will be convert from CFG to CNF or GNF. This will be the format. A context-free grammar will be given to you and you will be asked to convert that into either CNF or GNF. They will mention it. You have to convert it into Chomsky's normal form or Grebash's normal form. This entire question may come for 5 or even 10 marks. Okay. One question is always there in the paper, either on CNF or GNF. If you're lucky, it may come for 10 marks, but again, the length of the problem may depend according to the weightage of that problem. Okay, so we can start this problem, we can start this lecture by first of all understanding what is the normality of Chomsky's normal form, and then we will move towards Grebash's normal form. Okay, so first up, this is Chomsky's normal form. One second. Yeah. So as you can see over here, a Chomsky's normal form, basically a context-free grammar without useless unit and null productions. मैंने पहले कहा था in the last lecture that before even starting with the normal forms, we should have a thorough knowledge of what exactly is simplification because it is the very first step of converting any grammar into a normal form. Okay, so the very first step is a context-free grammar without useless unit and null productions is set to be in CNF if. Now here is the normality of this grammar. If A produces BC, it simply means that on the left hand side you will be having the variable and on the right hand side you will be having a production which has to be strictly in this format. That is, a production A, whatever be the name of the production, should give two variables only. Samjha sabko? It cannot be a combination of a variable or a terminal. It cannot be a combination of two terminals or multiple terminals. It has to be in the format of left hand side variables should produce two variables only on the right hand side or a single terminal. These are the two conditions. Am I clear? So basically the grammar have to be converted into such a format where on the right hand side you should only have two variables or a single terminal. Then only it can be considered as a CNF. Am I clear? Kindly let me know. Okay. I don't want any confusion over here क्योंकि problems इसके ऊपर based है. So if you're having any slightest confusion, kindly ask me right now only. Because A is the variable, the name of the variable obviously will be different. This is just a general format given to you. A variable, that is left hand side variable, should produce either two variables or a single terminal. This is what we call as the Chomsky's normal form. It is very simple. Now the only task is we need to convert a CFG into a CNF. So what are the various steps? Okay, let's have a look. I will go through these steps and then we can start the problems. These are the steps. Out of these two normal forms, Chomsky's normal form is the simplest one. So we are starting with CNF and then we will move towards GNF. Okay. So the steps are like this. The very first thing is you have to eliminate the unit, null and useless productions. Okay, order doesn't matter. You can eliminate any of these in any sequence. The only concern is you need to simplify the grammar. That's it. Okay. First step is simplification of grammar. You can write within brackets over there. This is nothing but simplification that we have done in the previous lecture. Okay. Second step is all about add to the solution the productions that are already in CNF. Okay. There might be possibilities that out of all the productions given, there might be few productions or few variables which are already in CNF. So what you need to do is you need to apne last lecture mein dekha tha, we had made two columns. Old production and new production, old production solution, something like that. So same thing you have to make over here. Okay, so whichever production is already in CNF, you have to take care of that. You don't need to make any changes to it. Okay, but for those productions which are not in CNF, you have to do some kind of changes which are like these. Okay, so for example, let's assume that we are having a production of this format. In this case, what shall we do? Any idea? Because this is not in CNF, right? I'm giving you the technique by which we actually convert it. Read the steps. Steps are given something like this. Replace the terminal by some variable. This is the most important hint that I can give you. Replace the terminal by some variable. So over here, which is the terminal which is causing us some problem? Because over here, this is not in CNF. For this to be in CNF, what we should do? Either we should have two variables on the right hand side. No, we can't replace B with an epsilon. We can't remove it because epsilon to nikalna hi hai na. We can't have epsilon in our grammar, Isha, because otherwise grammar simplify to hoga hi nahi. We can't make use of epsilons, null characters, unit productions, etc. Because wo humne pehle hi step mein remove kar liya hai. Okay, so think of something else. It is mentioned in the first step, replace the terminal by some variable. So first of all, find out the terminal which is causing us some issue. Over here, the terminal which is causing us some issue is this terminal C. Yes, because we want two variables on the right hand side or a single terminal. Over here in this case, it's a combination of a terminal followed by a variable. So what we can do is we can introduce a new variable. For example, x produces c. So if I do something like this, this entire thing gets converted into something like this. Now, are both of these productions in CNF? Yes or no? A produces XB and capital X produces C. So now you can see that with a simple substitution, we can convert this piece of context-free grammar into a CNF. That is, it has to follow, all the productions have to follow both the either of these rules. That is, either it should have a single terminal on the right-hand side, or it should have two variables on the right-hand side. Okay, so if it satisfies either of these rules, then it will be considered as a CNF. So with a simple substitution, we have converted a CFG into a CNF. Aise problems aayenge, but obviously there would be more number of productions. Okay, so second rule is limit the number of variables or non-terminals on the right-hand side of the production to two. That we have already seen. We can have only two variables on the right-hand side. We can't have more than two variables, or even less than two variables. We need to have a strict format that is only two variables or a single terminal on the right-hand side. This is what we call as a Chomsky's normal form. Am I clear till here? Kindly let me know so that I can proceed ahead with the problems based on this particular algorithm. Okay, so shall I proceed ahead with the problems? I have 4 to 5 problems on CNF and same with GNF also. So let's see. I will go slow, otherwise you won't understand how it is happening. Okay, so just have a look. This is your first problem which you need to solve. I have solved it step by step as it's the very first problem. Then I expect you to solve the other ones. Okay, so the first question is something like this. S produces AB, BA, whatever is the production. Our very first rule, our very first step is to check whether we can do any simplification to the grammar or not. Now you only tell me, can you simplify this grammar any further? If yes, then which production? Simplification applies to all the three rules, null, unit and useless. So very first thing is go through these productions and then check whether you can do any further simplification to it or not. And if yes, what is the simplification? Do let us know. Over here, I can see S is calling AB. Okay, fine. S is calling BA. So both A and B are reachable from the start symbol. So I can say that they are not useless. Correct? I can't see any null production over here. So I can clearly say that there is no null production over here. Only thing left is unit. Whether if any unit production is present over here, I can't see any unit production. Am I clear? I'm just repeating once again. Can you see any null production over here? Obviously, there are no null productions. So that part is stricken off. Second is, we don't have any useless productions because both B is reachable, A is reachable, and I can't see any self loops in any of these because even if there is a loop over here, other productions are also being called. So I can't say that this is a self loop or an infinite loop. Hence, A and B are not useless. So I can straight away say that no further simplification is required because there are no useless, no unit, as well as no null productions. So in the exam, you have to first of all mention a step, that is simplification, step number one. If any simplification is possible, mention that over here, solve it and mention it. Otherwise, kindly write over there that the grammar is already simplified and no further simplification is required. So that is what I'm writing over here. The same you have to write in the exam. In your own words, you can write, obviously. I'm just giving you a template. Okay. So in the exam, if a particular problem needs simplification and you haven't done any simplification, and you have straight away started with the conversion, then your entire problem is wrong. You will get 0 marks even if you have written for 4 to 5 pages. Still, your problem would be wrong. okay, you won't get even a single mark for it. Because your first step itself would be wrong and the entire problem would be considered wrong. Okay, so let's start this problem. Now you only tell me which are those productions that are already in CNF. That was our next step, right? Rule number one, to check whether any of the productions are in CNF or not. So out of these, which are in CNF, I will mention over here. See over here clearly, capital B produces B is in CNF. This is in CNF. Apart from those, I can't see any other production in CNF. Yes or no? Kindly have a look. Variable produces a single terminal, or variable produces two variables. That is what is the condition for a CNF. I can see that A produces terminal A and B produces terminal B. Only these are the two productions which are already in CNF. Apart from that, any other value can you see over here? No, I can't see any other value over here, right? So can we start? So this is the table which you need to construct. On the left hand side there will be the production, and on the right hand side there will be the solution. So start off with all those productions which are already in CNF. Okay, so how to start off? The very first thing you need to do is, on the left hand side in this production column, simply write the production that is in CNF. In my case, it is A produces A. Okay, so on the right hand side you don't need to make any changes. So basically, this solution column is all about the final productions. Okay, on the left hand side there are the input productions, and on the right hand side you need to write the final productions that should be mentioned at the end. Okay, so this is already in CNF, this is already in CNF. Now we should move ahead and start filling up the other productions. So we have completed so far till this. Each and every production has to be in CNF. So aapko har ek production ko one by one consider karna hai and then check whether they can be converted into CNF or not. So what I have taken is, you can either start with this A production or you can start with this B production. I am starting with this A production. So A ka agla production kya hai? That is A produces AS. So that is what I have written over here. A produces AS. Now as you can see that, like the previous examples, chota wala example jo maine solve kiya tha, this is not in CNF. Now you need to do some substitutions. So what are those substitutions? You simply need to convert this terminal which is causing you problem into a variable. That is this terminal A over here. Now what we can do, we can convert this terminal A into a variable. Okay, take a different variable, a variable which should not resemble this A, B, S, etc. So I have taken some a different looking variable, that is C1. So I have taken a variable C1 just to mention that this is a variable which I have taken apart from what is being given to me. Am I clear? So C1 produces A. So if I replace this A with C1, what will be this production now turn out to be? This A variable, this A production will now be referred to as A produces C1S. Am I correct? Kindly let me know yahan tak samjha ki nahi. Then only I shall move ahead. So I'm simply highlighting all those productions which are already in CNF. So right now we have completed this four productions. Okay, clear till here. Similarly, we can move ahead. Let me give you a small hint. First of all, start with the strings which are of length 1. Then move ahead with strings of length 2, 3, 4, etc. So length 1 humne already cover kar liya hai, that is a single terminal. Now we are moving ahead with length 2. So I can either select this BS or I can select this. So I'm going with the flow. I am taking BS. So next is B produces BS. In the same fashion, you have to convert this small b into one more variable. So I have taken C2. Now C2 is B, hence this B production will get converted to C2S. Just make sure that whatever conversions, whatever substitutions you are making, they are also in CNF. As we can see, C2 produces B, that is C2 is a variable, and on the right hand side we have a single terminal. So again, this is also in CNF. Otherwise, ye pura question wrong ho jayega. Sirf itna dhyan mein leke chalna hai. Whatever substitutions you are making, aage samjhega main kyun bol raha hu ye, that also should be in CNF. समझा। सो नाउ वी हैव कंप्लीटेड, ए प्रोड्यूसेस ए एस, बी एस, ये चार हो गए। नाउ लेंथ टू वाले दो बचे हमारे पास, एस प्रोड्यूसेस ए बी एंड एस एस प्रोड्यूसेस बी ए। इन द सेम फैशन वी हैव टू डू इट। नाउ जस्ट मेक श्योर दैट एस प्रोड्यूसेस ए बी, राइट? बट एज वी हैड ऑलरेडी रिप्लेस्ड ए विथ सी वन, देर इज नो नीड टू इंट्रोड्यूस वन मोर वेरिएबल सी थ्री एज ए, बिकॉज वो सिंपली रिपीटेटिव हो जाएगा। आर यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग? वी हैव ऑलरेडी टेकन सी वन एज ए एंड वी आर गोइंग टू रिप्लेस ए विथ सम वेरिएबल, सो डोंट टेक अनदर न्यू वेरिएबल सी थ्री ओवर हियर, बिकॉज वी ऑलरेडी हैव टेकन अ रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ ए एज सी वन। एम आई क्लियर? सो यू सिंपली नीड टू रिप्लेस ए बाई सी वन ओवर हियर, दैट सिंपली बिकम्स एस गिव्स सी वन बी। क्लियर? यहां मिस्टेक मत करना, बिकॉज ए हैज ऑलरेडी बीन टेकन एज समथिंग एल्स विच वॉज सी वन, सो मेक श्योर इट इज रिप्लेस्ड विथ सी वन ओनली। क्लियर? ओके, लेट्स मूव अहेड। नेक्स्ट इज एस प्रोड्यूसेस बी ए। नाउ वी नो दैट बी इज सी टू, सो एस विल बी सी टू ए। क्लियर? सो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड ऑल दी स्ट्रिंग्स ऑफ लेंथ टू। नाउ वी शैल मूव अहेड विथ स्ट्रिंग्स ऑफ लेंथ थ्री, विच इज दिस वन, दैट इज बी ए बी। अगर मैं यही पे चेंजेस करूं तो इट बिकम्स एज वी नो दैट बी इज सी टू, ओके, सो इट बिकम्स सी टू ए बी, बट एज यू कैन सी दैट सी टू ए बी इज नॉट इन सी एन एफ, सो वी नीड टू मेक सम मोर चेंजेस। वी नीड टू टेक वन मोर वेरिएबल सो दैट कैन कन्वर्ट दिस इन टू अ सी एन एफ फॉर्मेट। कैसे करोगे? यू ओनली टेल मी। देर आर टू पॉसिबल वेज by which we can do this. We can either take this ab as a new variable, which is the new variable in this case. I mean, next kya hoga? c3. Yeah, so we can take c3 over here. Either we can replace this ab with a c3, then what a becomes? A becomes c2 c3. Am I clear? Yeah, we can take c3 as ab. This also is in cnf, correct? Or we can take, or we can do one more thing, that is we can consider C2A as C3. Whatever you wish to do. Isme order matter nahi karta. In that case, A would be C3B, if I'm not wrong. Yeah. Dono mein se kuch bhi chalega. S kahan se aaya? Correct? So the simplest is you can do this one, that is you can consider this AB as C3, because wo aapko dikhne mein easy pad raha hai, don't rather instead of combining C2 with some other variable, you can combine AB as C3. This is better, I guess. So the new production that you will get is somewhat like this, that is A gives C2 C3. लास्ट बचता है बी। बी क्या है? व्हाट इज बी? बी इज ए बी बी ए। एज वी नो दैट ए इज सी वन, सो इट बिकम समवॉट लाइक दिस। नाउ व्हाट यू कैन डू, अगेन यहां पे आपको दो वेरिएबल्स लेने ही पड़ेंगे, देर इज नो अदर ऑप्शन। हाउ यू विल प्रोसीड, टेल मी, because we don't have anything bb ba, kuch hamare paas hai nahi, which is already being replaced by some other variable. We have c3 as ab, but over here we are having ba, so we can't make use of already existing variables, so we have to introduce new variables. And for that reason, what we have done is we have considered this ba as c4. Okay, so what we are doing is, let me show it over here. We have considered this ba as c4 and this C1B as C5. We can't replace BBA with a variable, Pratik. Wohi main bar bar bol raha hu. Can we replace BBA with a variable? No, because again this won't be in CNF. Wohi to main bol raha hu. Have a look. Jo bhi replacement hum kar rahe, that should also be in CNF. So far, whatever replacements we have done, those all replacements are also in CNF. But if I do something like this, this will not be in CNF. That's why we have to consider two variables ka pair and convert them into a variable. Okay, so that is what we have done. We have taken BA together and replaced them with C4. we have taken c1 b together and replaced them with c5. So at the end we will get b gives c5 c4. Okay, am I clear now? कुछ नहीं है, सिर्फ रिप्लेसमेंट है, दैट्स इट. कैन वी रिप्लेस ए बी विथ वन वेरिएबल? नो, वी कैन वी रिप्लेस ए बी विथ वन वेरिएबल एंड बी ए विथ अनदर वेरिएबल? ओके, लेट मी चेक. ए बी, स्मॉल ए बी यू आर सेइंग, राइट? दैट इज ऑलरेडी रिप्लेस विथ एस ना, एस, ए बी इज ऑलरेडी एस, सो वी डोंट नीड वन मोर वेरिएबल टू रिप्लेस इट. वी ऑलरेडी हैव एस प्रोड्यूसर्स ए बी, फॉर दैट रीजन ओनली वी हैव टेकन A as C1 and taken it as S produces C1B. You can't simply take a combination of a terminal and variable and replace it by a variable X, because that won't be in CNF. So whatever replacements you are making, that should also be in CNF. That is why maine A ko replace kiya tha with C1, so that X becomes C1B. Now this is in CNF. Am I clear, Ayush? Can we use S as replacement variable? S is already a production, na? Then it will create a lot of confusion, because already S is AB, and if you are considering S as the replacement variable, so kaise chalega? You have to take a new production, new variable, because the old variable S was not in CNF. That is why we are taking something new, which is now in CNF. Clear? So at the end, what you need to do is, सबका कॉम्बिनेशन, सारे प्रोडक्शन हमें मिल चुके हैं. वॉट यू नीड टू डू इज एट द एंड सिंपली राइट ऑल द प्रोडक्शन विच यू हैव गॉट. दैट विल बी योर फाइनल स्टेप. दैट इज यू नीड टू मेंशन फाइनल प्रोडक्शन. ओके, सिंपली राइट डाउन ऑल द प्रोडक्शन दैट यू हैव गॉट. दैट इज एस गिव्स सी1 बी. आई एम राइटिंग इट ओवर हियर. C2A, you can match your answers with mine. A gives small a, C1S, C3B, B gives small b, C2S, C4, C5. Anything left? You only tell me, anything left over here? Do I have a correct solution for this, or is anything left for the Kindly let me know. On. Just check this and let me know whether it is the final solution or we need to make anything, we need to make any more changes. Yes, correct. We need to add the C values also. So basically C1 is A, C2 is B. Don't forget this, otherwise marks nahi milega, because you have made these replacements. So you need to mention those replacements in the final solution also. Okay. Now, you might be having a query in your mind. I know that. What if I take something else as C1? Over here, I have taken C1 as A. If I take X as A or Y as B, is it possible? Yes, you can take it. The only concern is, you can even make different changes. Jaise maine yahan pe bataya tha, if you remember, if I replace this A with C1, it becomes C1BBA. I can either take combination of these, or I can take combination of these also. But वो अलग हो जाएगा. Basically, suppose यहाँ पे एक और value है ऐसा. Okay. If I take combination of these and then combine this, any value you can consider. Okay. Any combinations you can consider, provided they are in sequence. But for example, I am getting answer as C1B. You might get answer as for example, C3, C2, whatever it said. The only thing is, at the end, you should have 5 extra productions. That's it. The count should be common for all. Okay. The count should be common for all. I have not, actually, I have simply copied it from my solution. Let me change it. If I have made any mistake, kindly let me know. A is, let me check, you are having queries with this A solution, right? Okay, let me check it. A is C2, C3, correct. Yeah, that is what I'm saying over here. See, mujhe A mein kya mila? I got A as C2, C3, I got A as C1, CS, and I got A as A. Okay, So that I have mentioned over here, C1s. This is according to you, this should be C2, C3. This could be C2, C3, no issues. That is what I'm saying. That mera answer, final wala, aapke answer se mismatch ho sakta hai. The only thing is, you have to count the total variables that you have got. Total number of variables have to be same. Because why this is happening is, the solution which I am having with me was solved using some other assumptions, and this solution jo maine live solve kiya, that is having some other assumption. That's it. That's why I have simply copied it. That's why it might have some changes. It's not a mistake. It's basically I have taken some different variable. That's why it is showing different answers. If I want, okay, let me complete it using this answer only. Then kuch confusion hi nahi hoga. Let me write it over here just for the sake of no changes. Okay. So this is C1B, C2A. S mein aur kya aayega? Do hi hai. Okay. Then A is nothing but small a. A is C1S. Aur kya hai A? C2, C3. What is B? Small b, C2S. And B, C5, C4. Okay. That's fine. That's clear. Okay. So basically, नीचे मैंने यहाँ पे क्या आंसर लिखा था, that was also correct, that was not incorrect, because if you see, जो मैंने आंसर यहाँ पे लिखा था, for example, I had written something like this, I had written C3B. Don't worry, if you are getting answer something like this, you simply need to check what is C3 over here, and then you will get the answer, whatever it is. If you see, C3 is C2A, so it is nothing but C2AB. What is C2? C2 is BAB. Somewhat aisa kuch tha. Let me check agar correct hai ya fir maine mistake kiya to. See over here, A is BAB. So can you see the difference? I had taken different variables, that's it. Answer is same. Can you see what I have done over here? Just to remove the confusion out of your mind, I am again explaining these things. I had this answer instead of C2, C3. So is it correct or incorrect? Yes, I am only saying, I'm saying that only, Praful. There might be different final productions. The only thing you have to consider is the total count will never be different. The total extra productions that you have taken will always be constant. That is why it's called a normal form. Okay. That is what I'm saying. Even I got it in 5 steps, in 5 productions. You will also get in 5 productions. That is why I have a different solution over here. I had C3B over here instead of C2, C3. Why? Because if you see, C3 is nothing but C2A. That is what I have written over here. And what is C2? C2 is B. So I'm again getting BAB only. You are also getting C2, C3 as BAB. So there is no harm in doing it. Just make sure that the final production should have the same number of extra productions, that is C1 to C5 or X1 to X5, whatever you take, that has to be constant. That is why it is called as a Chomsky's normal form, because the final productions will always be having same number of productions. Clear with it? Can we move ahead? Any doubts in this? You can ask me. Okay. So for our purpose, what we can do is we can take a particular syntax. We can take a particular value. For example, let's stick with C1, let's stick to C2, etc. So that sabke answer same aaye. Otherwise, sabke answer alag alag aayenge, to live lectures mein it will create a lot of problems. Okay. So let's move on with the next problem. Next problem is like this. Let me get rid of this. Next problem is very simple. Just you need to do some changes. Just a second. Yeah. Just have a look at this problem. The 00S, 11S, 01 epsilon.
So what is the very obvious thing you can see over here? What is the step number one? Very obvious thing. Epsilon, correct. Null production, correct. So that is your very first step. You have to eliminate the null production. You have to simplify the grammar. So wherever epsilon is present, replace that in S, right? Because epsilon is being called inside S. So our first step is simplification of grammar. I can only see a null production over here. You can't say there is a unit production because it is not useless, as well as it is not having unit productions. Okay, so replace epsilon in S. So kya hoga? Let me show you. As you know, again we have to make a column, a table basically, old production and solution. And solution. So first this S gives 0 0 S. So if I replace this S with an epsilon, I will get a new production that is 0 0. Similarly, S gives 1 1 S. So if I replace S with an epsilon, I will get 1 1. Okay. Next up, okay, that's it, because there are no more productions which are having epsilon. So these are your new productions that you need to add in your final solution. Okay, so if I add it into my final solution, it simply becomes something like this. S gives 0 0 S, S gives 1 1 S, S gives 0, S gives 1, S gives 0 0, S gives 1 1. Am I correct? So this is your production which you need to work upon now. Just make sure you are simply eliminating the epsilon production. You are not eliminating this. गलती से भी आप ये मत सोचना कि एप्सिलॉन हमने एस में पुट किया है तो ये एस का वैल्यू भी निकल जाना चाहिए. नो, इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट. ये तब होता है कौन से केस में? व्हेन वी अप्लाई इट फॉर यूनिट प्रोडक्शन. इफ यू रिमेम्बर, वी हैड ऑलरेडी सीन इट. नल प्रोडक्शन के केस में वी आर सिंपली एलिमिनेटिंग द प्रोडक्शन विच इज कॉजिंग द नल, दैट इज दिस पर्टिकुलर नल वैल्यू वी हैव रिमूव. सो नल वैल्यू को रिप्लेस करेंगे हम एस में. जो भी रिजल्टेंट आएगा वी सिंपली एड दैट एज एन एक्स्ट्रा प्रोडक्शन. समझा? वही चीज हमने यहाँ पे अप्लाई किया. सो नाउ दिस इज योर न्यू प्रोडक्शन. यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट दिस इनटू अ सीएनएफ. इट्स वेरी सिंपल. स्टार्ट कैसे करेंगे? लेट्स सी. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दोस प्रोडक्शंस दैट आर ऑलरेडी इन सीएनएफ, आई एम डूइंग इट इन शॉर्ट. ओके, एस प्रोड्यूसेस 0, दैट इज इन सीएनएफ. एस प्रोड्यूसेस 1, दैट इज इन सीएनएफ. Now what you can do is you can take a new variable C1 as 0. How? Because as you can see over here, we can use that C1. So now what happens is S can be converted to C1 C1. Am I correct? I'm talking about this. S can be converted into C1 C1. Similarly, I can take a new variable C2 as B. Sorry, not B, 1. What we can do is, as you can see, this production is nothing but S gives C2, C2. Am I correct? कर सकते हैं कि नहीं? Yes. So what else? आगे क्या करेंगे? Now, as you can see, this is we have completed this much. Now we know that 0 0 S करना है हमें. So how to proceed? 0 0 S चाहिए. So how can we proceed? Any idea? You only tell me. C3 ले सकते हैं ना हम लोग? Can we take C3 as 0 0? यस, वॉट एवर. अपने चेंजेस आप कुछ भी ले सकते हो. जस्ट मेक श्योर कि एंड में यू गेट द सेम अमाउंट ऑफ वेरिएबल. सो आई कैन सी समथिंग लाइक दिस. इट बिकम्स C3S. योर सोल्यूशन माइट बी डिफरेंट देन माइन. जस्ट मेक श्योर दैट टोटल नंबर ऑफ वेरिएबल्स एट द एंड आर कॉन्स्टेंट. सिमिलरली आई कैन टेक C4 एज 1 1. सो वी कैन रिप्लेस दिस एज C4S.
हो गया।
और कुछ बचा? तो अकॉर्डिंग टू मी योर आंसर शुड रीच C4, C4 तक जाना चाहिए आंसर। C4 तक गया एंड इफ ईच एंड एवरी प्रोडक्शन इज इन CNF देन इट्स अ करेक्ट आंसर। तो बेसिकली ये एक्सटर्नल्स और एग्जामिनर्स के ऊपर थोड़ा हेडेक हो जाता है बिकॉज दे नीड टू चेक ईच एंड एवरी आंसर सेपरेटली। देर इज नो फिक्स्ड आंसर फॉर अ पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम। द वेरी फर्स्ट थिंग दे नीड टू चेक इज इफ द वेरिएबल्स आर सेम अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर सोल्यूशन। नंबर ऑफ वेरिएबल्स शुड बी सेम अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर सोल्यूशन एंड देन दे नीड टू चेक ईच एंड एवरी सोल्यूशन इन डेप्थ। तो यू शुड गेट एन आंसर विच should have the last variable as C4. So let me rewrite all the production once again and that should be your answer. S gives 0, 1, C1, C1, C2, C2, C3S and C4S. Similarly, C1 is 0, C2 is 1, C3 is 0, 0, and C4 is 1-1. This is my solution. This might be different from yours, obviously, but just make sure you get the answer till C4. Solve it and let me know whether you got the answer. No issues if you are not getting exactly same answer as mine. That is what I have been repeating from the last 10 minutes. You may get a different answer. Just make sure the final variable is C4. Let me give you an alternate solution. So in case you are having that solution in your mind, okay? This happens a lot. I come up with a different solution every single time because har time dimag thoda alag kaam karta hai. So it's quite possible. Just make sure the answers are same. Okay. This is an alternate solution. You may get alternate solutions. So just cross check the two solutions I have written over here. There might be more solutions to it. Okay. Kindly let me know if it is clear. Do reciprocate your knowledge and tell me whether it's correct or not. Okay. So as I was saying, you might have different solutions, no issues. Clear? So can we move ahead? I have two more problems on CNF. If time permits, I can give you some homework questions also. Because we will be meeting next week directly. Okay. So let's move ahead with the third question of the day. Question number three. Oh, sorry. Today is Monday. I totally forgot. Yeah, we'll be meeting on Friday. Sorry. I thought this was Friday. No issues. So question number three. This is S gives AABB, AABB and B. Yeah. So solve it. Let me solve this question. Can I replace S with 00B as S with C1? No, Manav. Why? Because that will not be in CNF. Na? C1, C1, S matlab teen terms aa jayenge. And we can't have three terms according to our rules of CNF. We can have two variables only. C1, C1B also, na? Three terms. Na? That is C1, C1B. You can have only two variables on the right hand side or a single terminal. Wohi rule follow karna hai har production mein. Samjha? Okay. So just have a look at this problem and try to solve it. First of all, tell me whether it is simplified or we need further simplification to it. यूनिट प्रोडक्शन किधर है विनय? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज यूनिट प्रोडक्शन।
यहाँ पे यूनिट प्रोडक्शन नहीं, यूनिट प्रोडक्शन तब होता अगर यहाँ पे ऐसा कुछ होता तो। यूनिट मीन्स सिंपल, सिंगल ना। देयर आर नो सेल्फ लूप्स ऑल्सो धीरज, एज यू कैन सी यू यू माइट गेट कंफ्यूज विद दिस कि यहाँ पे सेल्फ लूप है। ओके, बट एज यू कैन सी दैट इट इज ऑल्सो हैविंग अ प्रोडक्शन बी, कॉल बी। So I can't say there is a self loop. Also, this can't be considered as a self loop. It is producing something. It is not useless. अगर यूजलेस होता, अगर सेल्फ, अगर यूजलेस होता तो सेल्फ लूप कंसिडर करते हैं हम लोग, बट इन दिस केस इट इज बीइंग कंसिडर्ड ओवर हियर। सपोज एक सेकेंड ध्यान से देखो, दिस इज अ वेरी क्रूशियल थिंग दैट यू शुड नोट। Although it looks like a self loop, okay. Although it looks like a self loop, but if I remove this, this will also get removed, and as a result, the entire grammar will be removed. Yes or no? आप पे ध्यान दो। तो सेल्फ लूप का एक स्पेशल क्राइटेरिया भी बोल सकते हो इसको। दिस इज अ सेल्फ लूप, नो डाउट, बट इफ आई रिमूव दिस, द एंटायर ग्रामर विल बी removed, and that is not possible. Am I clear? Because if I remove this variable a, then it will be removed from here also, and we can't say that if I remove a, it will be considered like this. No. If I remove any occurrence of a, then the entire production will get removed, and as a result, entire s will get removed. But that is not possible. If they have given a production, then it should lead to a solution. Correct? That's why even though it's a loop, but it is not useless. तो वो चीजें ध्यान में रखो। Okay, whenever you see that a particular variable is looping in itself, kindly have a look कि s में उसका क्या importance है। If I remove that, if I remove it, if after removing that particular variable, if the entire s production gets removed, then it is not a self loop. Am I clear? It might sound confusing, but you can't have a grammar with no productions at all. Samajh rahe ho? So if I remove this A, the entire grammar will collapse, and that is not possible. Correct? Any comments from your side? Any doubts? Any questions? So even if it is a loop, we need to check whether it is useful or useless. In that case, Ayush, A will be the final state. The machine will stop over there. Basically, क्या आंसर हमें देखना है? We need to check whether that particular variable is useful or useless. वही कंसर्न है ना हमारा. So if the machine moves into A, it will somehow stop over there as a halting condition. But if that entire variable is removed, the entire grammar will collapse. अगर यहाँ पे कुछ और साथ में होता, for example, A, B, then we could have simply removed the production of A from here. We will get the output, no issues. Samjha? But if the S production itself is having a single production on the right-hand side, and that is having capital A in one of its productions, then we can't remove it, because in that case, it won't be a useless production. Am I clear? Similarly, yahan pe kuch aur hota production along with it, then we could have easily removed it. Okay, but now in this case, as it is the only production being used in the start symbol, we can't remove it. यही है कि अलग अलग क्वेश्चन में अलग अलग थोड़े बहुत लॉजिक बैठते हैं, दैट्स इट। तो कैन वी स्टार्ट अहेड? एज वी कैन सी दैट देर आर नो सिंप्लीफिकेशन पॉसिबल, देर इज नो नल सिंबल प्रेजेंट, देर इज नो यूनिट सिंबल प्रेजेंट। सेल्फ लूप था, बट इट इज जस्टिफाइड नाउ आई गेस। तो कैन वी मूव अहेड? ओके, सो लेट्स कन्वर्ट दिस इनटू अ CNF. What is the very obvious thing you can see over here? What is the very first thing that we can convert? As we know that we can consider this A as C1, yes or no? Similarly, we can take this B as C2. Okay, what we can do is we can write A as C1A, and we can write this B as C2B dot. Clear? So last thing left is S produces, ABB. In that case, what we can do is we need to take combinations जो हमने पहले किए थे. तो as you can see, it is nothing but it is C1A C2B. So what you can do is you can take combinations out of it. So you can take a new variable C3. C3 could be C1A and C4 could be C3B. Over here we can write C3 C4. Is it correct now? यस और नो? मैंने शॉर्ट में लिखा है, आपको स्टेप बाय स्टेप जाना है. हाउ कम स्टेप बाय स्टेप? एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी शोन इन द फर्स्ट प्रॉब्लम, इफ एस इज समथिंग लाइक दिस, एस इज AA BB, देन व्हाट यू नीड टू डू इज इन द नेक्स्ट स्टेप, दो हमारे कॉलम्स थे ना, तो इन दिस स्टेप व्हाट यू कैन टेक, यू कैन कंसिडर C3 एज C1A, बिकॉज A इज ऑलरेडी C1. यू कैन टेक C4 एज C3B, then it becomes S produces C3 C4. That is what I have done in a single step over here. So in the end, you are yes. Why are you making mistakes? See, simple. Dekho, if I write B as C C2, will it be in CNF? Yes or no? वही तो conversions कर रहे हैं ना हम लोग. CNF has to be either a single terminal or two variables on the right hand side. That's why we can't have C2 on the right hand side. तो सिंप्लीफाई करने के लिए ही तो हमने ये C2 लिए हैं, C2 एंड CA लिए हैं. Yes or no? हाँ सॉरी, C2 भी यहाँ पे C2 आएगा. देखते बाकी और कुछ मिस्टेक, एनीथिंग एल्स? ओके क्लियर. Is running slow today. Don't know why, internet speed maybe. Okay, so anything else you want clarification on? Is it clear or anything else is left? I guess C1 is left. Yeah, it is being written over here. So if I want to rewrite the entire grammar once again, it will be something like this. Let me rewrite it over here. S will produce, S will be having how much, how many productions? Only a single production, that is C3 C4. A is nothing but A is comprising of a single loop, if I'm not wrong. उसके ऊपर ये तो पूरा कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी था हमारा. सो इट इज नथिंग बट C1A एंड B इज नथिंग बट द न्यू प्रोडक्शन विच वी हैव इंट्रोड्यूस, दैट इज BB, दैट इज C2B B, एंड देन रीराइट ऑल द प्रोडक्शन C1 C2 C3 C4. इफ रिक्वायर्ड लेट मी राइट इट वंस अगेन. C1 इज A, C2 इज B, C3 is C1A and C4 is C2B. Am I clear? Okay, so these are your new productions, final productions for this particular problem. So confusion सिर्फ एक ही जगह पे था, लूप पे. So I'm repeating once again, if there is a loop, don't straight away discard it. First of all, check whether it is useful or useless. Okay, if you see that in production S, there are further more variables present which might not be having this variable A, then you can simply remove this A from this production and also from the start production. But if it is the only production present in A, sorry, in S, then don't remove it. That will not be a, what you can say, that will not be a useless production. Yeah, Jimit, the benefit of converting into normal form is it will be very easy for lexical parsers, or what you can say, for string pattern matching. Because if we know the variable, we can simply pass the variable value instead of passing all the terminal values. It will be easy to pass the variables. जैसे हम प्रोग्रामिंग में करते हैं, we only pass the variable and the value is automatically fetched from that variable. So it becomes really easy for lexical analysis and storing the variables. Okay, and time consuming नहीं होगा. It will be faster as compared to passing the single terminals one by one. We are simply passing the variable values. Because ultimately, all this entire structure, entire subject is basically used for automation. So at the end, we are learning how to match patterns, how to decide whether a particular string will be accepted or not. So this will really come handy for string matching. Even Google makes use of regular expressions, and regular expressions are based on this technique only. Clear? So let me drop in the attendance link, and in the meantime, kindly take this as your homework question. Okay.